Collagen is the main protein in the human body, found in skin, tendons, ligaments, and other connective tissues. It's also a popular supplement and a beauty product ingredient that claims to improve the health of your skin. Further than this, you may have heard that it helps improve skin elasticity, helps promote joint health, build muscle, burn fat, and more. So in this video, I'll go over what collagen supplements are, how they are claimed to work, whether or not they do work, and if you should pick some up. So stay tuned till the end. Hi guys, you've seen Arsalan, Media Pharmacist here on YouTube. This week's video is on collagen and its peptides. If you're new to the channel, I talk about health and wellness topics and try to bring as much value as I can to you guys, answer questions, and really build a strong community of people who just love healthy living. Smash the like button below now, as there's a ton of useful information in here and that will greatly support my channel. Also, while you're at it, hit that subscribe button too to stay up to date with new weekly videos. And without further ado, let's talk collagen. Most collagen supplements are sourced from animals, particularly pigs, cows, and fish. They typically contain collagen types 1, 2, and 3, or a mixture of the three, and prepped into three forms: raw collagen, which is undenatured, gelatin, which is partially broken down, and hydrolyzed collagen, or collagen peptides, the most popular form, which are broken down into tiny amino acids, which I'll get into, so stay tuned till the end. Collagen is responsible for making sure our skin doesn't sag, giving us that youthful appearance that's wrinkle-free. Everyone wants to look young and feel young, right? Right, which is why, according to the Nutrition Business Journal, Americans spent an estimated $122 million on collagen supplements in 2018, an increase compared to the year before, and the global market is looking at $5 billion so far in 2020. Your body is going to naturally make collagen as much as it can, so don't worry, until the production decreases the older you get. Our bodies are not able to replace the collagen we're losing as quickly as it's breaking down. And get this, starting in our 20s, we begin losing about 1% of our collagen each year, and because we lose all this collagen, we start looking for answers over the counter. But are they actually there? Collagen supplements, when ingested, can't target specific parts of your body, and your body might not even recognize that you just took your collagen. Believe me, I wish this was the fountain of youth, but sadly it might not be. So if you know where the fountain of youth is, comment down below. There just isn't a direct highway from your stomach to your skin, nails, and bone. And that's an important point to make. The claims that collagen will be shuttled by your cells to the appropriate areas are not backed by science. The issue is that most things we ingest are broken down by stomach acids and are not absorbed into the bloodstream all the way. It's actually unclear if we absorb ingested collagen or if it's totally broken down and lost in the stomach. And if it does make its way there, it'll likely be in its own individual amino acid form when it finally gets absorbed into your body. So we get it, the stomach is just gonna break it down. What about collagen creams though? Because collagen is produced in the deeper level of the skin called the dermis, which is lower than the epidermis, it's very hard for the topical collagen that you apply to actually make it there. They have molecular weights that are too large to penetrate the top layer of the skin, and usually only molecules the size of 500 Daltons or less can effectively cross the skin barrier. I get that as well, which is why they're hydrolyzed collagen peptides. Sounds fancy, but I'll admit they're better absorbed into the bloodstream because they're much shorter chained amino acids that technically can be broken down to possibly be more bioactive, possibly. This is still up for debate because it comes to the question of how much is actually readily available to be taken up when it arrives at the dermis. We just don't know. We still need an objective wide-scale study using a larger population focusing on collagen to determine the long-term effects of this product. The studies that exist citing the benefits of collagen for skin are funded by the same manufacturers of collagen that get you to buy their product. And many of the studies that looked at collagen benefits for bone health were done on animals. So what's the alternative? In terms of products, well, we have topical treatments like retinol and tretinoin that are scientifically proven to promote collagen formation. We also have antioxidants that are found in vitamin C serums, which may reverse the inflammation that causes damage to the collagen in your skin. In terms of lifestyle changes, which I recommend first, are making sure to wear a broad spectrum sunscreen to protect against UV light from the sun, as this breaks down collagen faster than you think. So it's important to wear sunscreen daily. Quitting smoking will prevent collagen destruction as well. So if you haven't considered quitting, now is a good time to do so, because the truth is, smoking will age you. And at the very least, you should focus on cutting out lifestyle habits that can break down collagen production to get as close as you can to treating the underlying condition without having to defy graceful aging. One final note, collagen is sold in the US as a dietary supplement and not as a medication, which means that the products are not closely regulated by the FDA. That means bottles that are labeled natural, certified, and verified are not standardized or regulated, so you run the risk of not getting the actual product written. So if you still decide to buy collagen, check to see if it carries the USP or the NSF logo on the label, as the products can at least be, you know, tested for contaminants or mislabeling. I hope this video was useful to you guys, and I hope that you do share this video with someone you know who can benefit from it. Like the video if you did enjoy it, and subscribe to stay on board with all my other weekly health and wellness videos. Thanks for sticking tuned all the way till the end, and as always, see you on the next one.